Good afternoon, what's up? My name is Demetrius Morgan. You already know what time it is. It's Chuck and Buck time. I'm trying to put together right now the fifth issue of Chuck and Buck. So right now we're getting ready to do so. I got my sketchboard here. I will be going step by step and showing, I guess, my process of how I do Chuck and Buck. So hopefully y'all enjoy just taking a look at the process of how I get down with writing, or finishing writing the stories, creating the characters by drawing them, and then taking it into Photoshop, Illustrator, and hopefully we can have all this wrapped up by tomorrow. Okay, so right now, this is the fifth issue again. So I'm drawing the third panel. And how it's gonna be, actually flip-flop, because I made a mistake and I actually put my main picture first, which is cool. I can be able to switch that around later on in Photoshop. But as for right now, I'm trying to, again, bring in the main focus of how important the baby aspect is, or the infant aspect is. Now with Grandma Grace, she's a character I developed years ago, and she kind of fits the setting for Chuck and Buck. That's how come she was added into the equation to be the, if not the mediator between the two. But also as a spiritual guide for the two, for Chuck and Buck, because one is at one opposite end of the spectrum, and the other is at the other opposite end of the spectrum. So that's why I like it has that, you know, that contrast in characters that, you know, makes up a good story. Again, Grandma Grace kind of filling her out here. Thank you. Yeah, so again, as you can see, this is what we're going with right here. This is the initial process. So this is a 11 by 17 comic board or comic page. I would advise you to definitely purchase that. That is a definitely need in comic creating. All right, here. About to go ahead and start to throw the inks down onto the illustration here. As you can see, I got my frame to how I want it. If I was to, again, take off this right here, you can see this is my frame, outer structure, what I'm working with right now. So now that I got that part done, I can then go in on a different layer and start to put in my inks. Thank you.
Okay, peoples, we are going in to the next phase of the project here, and which would be the flattening stage. I like to pick a color scheme before I head into my flats, so I can have something to go off on. So here, I would do my flats. Let me put them on top of there. Okay. Unlock that, but double that, there you go, okay, the bottom, all right, one, all right, we'll go ahead and set this on multiply. Okay, next we are going to pretty much label this layer flats. Okay, let's go back here. Let's choose a nice color where obviously pink will be in this area. Blue in this area, so on. So we'll go with a nice, I would say we'll choose this color. We'll choose this color here. Actually, should we just go with a gray? Yeah, let's go with a grayscale first. So with a grayscale, I'll be going maybe like a, let's go 50% right now so we can see what we're doing first. All right. Drop the grayscale on here. I'll zoom in here. As far as the I will go in, I would say let's start. My anti-alias, let's set up on my tools. My anti-alias for my polygonal lasso tool is set to checked off of me. Then we can go to our paint buckets, make sure our anti-alias is set off on that as well, just as well as the contiguous, the opacity at 100, tolerance at 0 tolerance. Then we also need to go to our magic wand, also check contiguous, if it's on, check it off, anti-alias checked off, and tolerance also at 0 notch. Then I believe we should be ready to rock and roll after that. Check my paint bucket tool. Yep, I'm ready to go. So, my first tool that I will be using here will be the, again, the polygonal tool. And then I'll just go in. I would kind of leave the outer boundaries untouched, but I'm going to just go in where, specifically where the glass, or where the frame rail would start. And we'll go from there.
Fun day, all work and no play, that's what parents say. I'm feeling good and risky, don't care, judge or diss me. Searching for a little mirror, this isn't dissing. Haters looking crispy, a con KFC's. Yeah, they fried, can't deny, but so is me. Depression never heard of PG, parental guidance. A fun tassimeter is a leader of defiance. Surfboard check, volleyball check. Looking good, check. You made it through the storm, torn from a big battle.
Now it's warm clouds,
sunny days in sand castle.
Alright, so let's go ahead and move along here. Right now, I am about to get back into the zone. So, thus far, you see, I'm going to finish up on a couple of more. Let's zoom in here. I'm about to start now getting into the rendering process of the colors, the base colors thus far. I'm satisfied with it. Maybe add a little bit more power to this. Ooh, gotta do the eyebrows. Again, finishing touches up on the flats, kind of fix up that little area right there. But so far, I'm kind of satisfied with the flats. Of course, doing flats is not an easy job. It is not. But let's go ahead and get back to work.
Illustrators, so now we're going to be doing the process of bringing the words together. I'm trying to get my words popping here. Come on. This is my normal font that I usually use. Ah, yeah. Which one was it? I know I just seen it. My back issues. Thank you. I don't know why I forgot the name of that. Yeah, but my back issues. Comic font, normally, if you want to choose to go another route, I read some Batman comics, which, again, they don't use the
back issues fonts. They use, you know, regular text fonts, I believe, maybe Arial or one of those fonts. But my point is, again, that again, your style towards your comic is your style. So whichever font that you choose to do, there's no set rules here. It's all about, you know, your approach and how you want your creativity to coincide with each other. So let's keep it moving. Thank the Lord. Thank my wife for helping me out, do the writing for this. And this is from a woman's perspective. I'm out the equation. Chuck's out the equation. Buck's out the equation. We don't want to mess with this. So we're going to leave this issue for the ladies, and hopefully we interpret this in a meaningful way for ladies, again, can get something out of it. Approximately took me quite some time. At least a little bit more than what I thought. Okay, here it is. So this is the final version of the Chuck and Buck issue number 5. It's called Premeditated Parenthood. These are the words. Let me zoom in on the words in here. Premeditated Parenthood. So y'all see my start to finish process. Again, I just added the words or the bubbles. And I didn't go with the bubbles, as far as like the balloon look or whatever. For the simple fact, man, you know, I'd rather let the color choose the voices here and what's going on, what's being said by whom, by what. Obviously, the green letterings here, or the green fonts, is going to be Grandma Grace. And you will know that as you read along. The green fonts is going to be Angela, and the black font will be Grandma Grace.
Yeah, thanks for tuning in. I will be definitely checking in with y'all always. Leave some comments, like, subscribe, tell people about what we're doing. And you know, if need be, join us in this expedition of bringing the word out in an artistic way, and keeping the truth no matter where we go. So, as always, keep it locked.